All people come to him, come to the way of Sultan Rabbiya, most honored one and most glorified one.
You knew something of knowledge, but the majority وغابت عنك أشياءه, and most of the knowledge disappeared from you. And this is a saying that we have to put in front of our heads, that we must not claim, all of us, that we know something. Every day technology is improving, but heavenly technology does not improve every day, because it is perfect up to the date. If one moment comes more, by itself it update, it upgrade itself to that moment. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, according to the time, according to the issue that happened in that time, that moment has a significance, and awliya Allah can see it, can understand it. That's why not all of them on the same level. Some of them, they might be able to dive in the ocean of knowledge and pull meanings and pull understanding. And some of them, they can still be at the beach, but they can put their feet in the ocean. There is a big difference. But still, you are in need for those feet. You are in need for everyone. Don't minimize people. Don't underestimate them. Might be someone sitting in this place here and he's a wali, we don't know. Who knows? Might be an angel sitting with us, for sure that. Because angels come on such associations. So in every moment of our life, there is something happening. And I said to myself today, I continue from what I spoke last Thursday. But this book came in my hand. So I said it's better to say what the Shaykh is saying. One of the greatest Shaykhs, he said, وَاعْلَمْ أَنَّ الْمَشَايِخَ يَنْظُرُونَ بِعُيُونِ أَفْئِدَتِهِمْ. You must know and establish within yourself to believe and to accept that scholars, mashayikh, which he means here, awliya Allah, they look at their followers with the eyes of their hearts. وَكُلْ اِعْمَلُوا فَسَيَرَ اللَّهُ عَمَلَكُمْ وَرُسُولُهُ وَالْمُؤْمِنُونَ. Allah said in Holy Quran, وَكُلْ اِعْمَلُوا, say, Ya Muhammad, to them, to act, to do, not only by tongue, but by action. It's a verb, وَكُلْ اِعْمَلُوا. Amal is the noun. Amalu is the verb. He say, do, act. There is a qawl, there is amal. There is a statement, and there is an action. The action is what is important, not the statement, You can make hundreds of statements. You can make hundreds of declarations. But what is important is for us to see what you are doing. What people, for us, as the ayah is saying, وَكُلْ اعْمَلُوا, do whatever you can, because Allah and His Prophet and Mu'mins are going to watch you. He didn't say, وَكُلْ اعْمَلُوا فَسَيَرَ اللَّهُ عَمَلَكُمْ وَرَسُولُهُ. In the previous ayah, he stopped there. He said, Allah will see your amal and His Prophet. In this ayah, same page, he said, do, and Allah will see your amal and His Prophet, and والمؤمنون. He add mu'min, that they are able to see. Who are these ones that they are able to see? وَقُلْ اِعْمَلُوا فَسَيَرَ اللَّهُ عَمَلَكُمْ. Do, act, Allah is going to look at your amal. وَرَسُولُهُ, and His Prophet is going to look at His amal. Then he added, وَالْمُؤْمِنُونَ, and the believers. That's why awliyaullah, Allah added them to the ayah to say, mu'min are going to see what you are doing. And they are going, if you are with them, they will look, he said, by the eyes of their heart. What's that mean? The heart has eyes. Every single tissue in the heart has eyes. Every single cell in the heart has an eye. That a wali can send through that cell his power to be able to see. Doctors, I don't know what they say about the heart. It's always working. For them, it has to work, moving. If it doesn't work, you die. So it is the most important organ in the body. The others, you might not die, but the heart, you might die if it stops. So the heart of the Shaykh is always in movement, looking at his Mureeds, what they are doing. And this is not any statement, it's an ayah in Holy Quran that Allah is saying, do, and He's looking at you, His Prophet is looking at you, and the mu'min are looking at you. Those awliya are looking at you. Wherever you are in China, and the Shaykh is in South Africa, can see you. وَيُرَاكِبُونَ بِنُورِ قُلُوبِهِمْ إِلَىٰ أَحْوَالِ الْمُرِيدِينَ. And they observe what their followers are doing. Are they doing according to Sharia? Or they are doing according to what? To tariqah? No one can do according to tariqah if he doesn't first do according to Sharia. Let it be clear. We are people that we believe in Sharia. And tariqah comes to support it in order that you can fly. Like something that you are using every day. Every one of us has a telephone. And sometime someone sends you a picture, a video clip. So the video clip comes to you and you cannot open it. they say it's too big file. So what? But you press to open it, it open, it doesn't show you anything, but it shows you that there is a circle turning. You saw that? Turning, see a doctor that? Turning, 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 for what? Why it's turning? I'm asking you, doctor.
Indicating time that it's...
That is going to open up. It turn until at the end it reach very small place. If that did not touch the other side, you cannot open the page. You cannot open the video clip. See that? No. When it begin to turn, the two sides, the right side this on the circle and the left side of the circle, has to meet in order that the video comes out. The majority of the circle is Sharia. That 1% is Tariqa. Because Sharia is what وَمَا أَتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ. Whatever Prophet gave to you from Sharia, take it. This is what you have to do. Tariqa comes later. When you take the bay'ah from the Shaykh and you become one of the Mureeds of the Shaykh, means you are that 1% far from connecting with the circle. The Shaykh duty is to connect for you that 1%. Sharia will be the 99%, Tariqa will be the 1%. Someone might say, but no, ya Shaykh, Tariqa is more than Sharia. No, Tariqa is not more than Sharia. Then if Tariqa is better than Sharia or more than Sharia, we don't pray. We don't fast. Subhanallah wa bihamdi. Don't know, the 99% is Sharia. 1% is Haqiqa, is reality, is Tariqa, is Marifa. When it connects, the light open up for you a gate to see what is inside. That time you can see, because that missing part is connected. So the duty of the Shaykh is to connect for you that 1% with the majority of the circle that is turning, what you call it, an app that makes it to turn. In order, when they catch each other, what comes out? The picture of video clip. When the sperm catch the egg, what will happen? A child come. A picture come. A life come. A soul come. That's why Allah wants, He say, Ya Muhammad, say to them, Allah is looking at them. Allah will be happy with those who are following what Prophet is giving them in order to achieve the reality. So he began Allah with himself, by himself. وَقُلْ اِعْمَلُوا فَسَيَرَ اللَّهُ عَمَلَكُمْ. Do, and Allah will see your work. It's not finished. You have to follow what Prophet has explained to you. And تركت فيكم سنتي وكتاب الله وسنتي. I left behind me for you the Holy Quran and my Sunnah. So means you have to obey the Holy Quran and the Sunnah of Prophet. So first step, obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ati'u Allah. Second step, ati'u Rasul. Third step, ulil amri minkum, or the mu'mins. So it is three steps. That's why when you say Allahu Akbar, you are obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's a prayer. Until you're sitting, you say at the end of the prayer, which it will clean you completely, now you will be sending salam and salawat on Prophet, on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, salam, salawat on Prophet, and salam to mu'mineen, and then you say, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, wa ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. That is the key for connecting this circle together. So if you do it in the right way, you are connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through your amal, to Prophet through your amal, to mu'min, to the shuyukh, that they will look what you have done and they fix it for you. When they do that, the best time for a wali to look at his followers, what they have done through the day, is the al-awqat al-sharifa, the holy, honorable times. And these times are before Salatul Fajr, Salatul Subh, by 1 hour. This is one of the best, the first best time that you do your awrad, you do your prayers, you do your fast, you do your prayers, you do your awrad. In that time, sitting by yourself. Then, after Fajr, after Subh, after the prayer, till Ishraq. That is one time. Two times, Sahar, Al-Qiyam, when you wake up before Fajr by 1 hour or half an hour or 10 minutes, whatever, before Fajr, and do your prayers. Then, after Fajr, then before Maghrib, between Asr and Maghrib, then between Maghrib and Isha. In these times, honorable, holy times, the wali has permission to look at his murid, what he has done of good and bad during the day. That's why Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, I observe the amal of my ummah. Not only I observe, تعرض علي عمل أمتي. They display for me the amal of my ummah. How many people here? Let's say whatever, 100, 200, 300, 500. Everyone, his amal is being displayed. If we are 500, 500 books are opened in front of Prophet. How? What kind of power Allah gave to Prophet to look at these 500 at the same time? And he clean that person and make istighfar on his behalf. At the same time, he's seeing everyone. This you are giving an example of 500, but Muslim Ummah is 1 billion, 2 billion. Every night, تعرض علي عمل أمتي, they display in front of me the amal of my Ummah, 2 billion people. That if we want to say to take the example of Ummatul Ijaba, the Ummah that they accepted Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, accepted Shahada. But the others are Ummatul Nabi, but they did not accept the Shahada. Still he see what they are doing. Until they make Shahada, he add them to his Ummatul Ijaba. So, what kind of power Allah gave to him can see 2 billion people, Muslim, in the same time displayed in front of him, and he will, if he see good, he said, فَإِذَا رَأَيْتُ حَسَنًا حَمَدْتُ اللَّهِ, I praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and thank him. If I see bad, I ask forgiveness on their behalf. And when he asks forgiveness on her, on their behalf, he will not stop until they will be forgiven from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. That one of the secret of the what we have sent Prophet as mercy for humanity. Mercy for them. A mercy for them in his life and after his life and before his life. He is mercy for everyone. And this is ayah in Holy Quran. So imagine the power of Awliyaullah. And Awliyaullah, many times I heard Grand Sheikh, may Allah bless his soul, says that there are 124,000 wali on the foot of 124,000 Nabi. Where are they? They are there. They are in the video clip, but you cannot bring them out. They are there. The video clip, they need the connection, the last 1% to connect with the circle in order that you can see the 124,000 wali. But unfortunately, we don't have that power in our eyes. Everyone is happy with, some people happy with what they have, some people are upset with what they have because it's not enough. And Allah said for us to be happy in everything. Look, the meanings of Holy Quran, what we call Alif Lam Mim, Kaf Ha Ya Ain Sad, Ha Mim Ain Sin Kaf, Alif Lam Mim Ra, Alif Lam Ra, what we call them? Muqatta'at. But they are ayah. It's an ayah by itself. After the opening of the Holy Quran, Surah Al-Baqarah, Ibn Abbas spent 7 years to learn it. The meanings, not memorized. He memorized it. You can memorize the whole Quran, but you will not act on it, on what you are memorizing, you lose it. 7 years. And it is said there is 10,000 ahkam in it. Rules. 10,000 rules in Surah Al-Baqarah alone. It means 10,000 judgment, 10,000 judgment, 10,000 information in Surah Al-Baqarah alone. And all of Surah Al-Baqarah is within the Alif Lam Mim. It is the video, heavenly video clip, if we can say that, for people, young ones, to understand. And inshallah, we spoke about it before, but we'll continue sometime else. But Alif Lam Mim. Alif is, we'll go into deep meaning with it, but not now, but now a little bit of it. Alif is the beginning of the Holy Quran, Al-Fatiha, and then Sab'al-Mathani, and then, because the whole Quran is in Al-Fatiha. So means Al-Baqarah is in the Fatiha, but it is one step more, it is in Alif Lam Mim. And why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after praising himself by himself, to himself in Surah Al-Fatiha, said Alif Lam Mim? That's for Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's not for us. Awliya Allah can take from Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's why tafsir of that is so deep that make you not stunned. Alif represent the first letter of Allah. The one owner, al-wujud, he is the owner of the existence, of everything existing. He is the owner. From him, the knowledge were descended to Prophet through whom? Through Jibreel alayhi salam. So the lamb represents Jibreel alayhi salam. The meem represent Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah, two letters, lam and lam, in it. Mulk wa malakut. Allah honor the mulk and the kingdom and malakut and heavens, with all what is inside, and it is being explained by Awliya Allah, especially Grand Shaykh and Mawlana Shaykh, the meanings. We next time, inshallah, we try to go into this meaning. The Ha in Allah is who, means the hidden treasure, the knowledge that it's hidden. Allah sent it to Jibreel. He sent it to Jibreel to send to Prophet. So the meme represent Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And when you pronounce meme, it is two memes, not one. And between them is what? Is the ya. Meme, 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 ya, meme. Means the first meme is the one that take directly from Jibreel alayhi salam, who takes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, hide it in the ya, the meem, the Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that facing Jibreel, will hide the knowledge in the ya, because the ya is, in Arabic grammar, is alif. So he put it back in the alif to be unseen, because he cannot show it to humanity. They cannot carry. So it will be descending in the second meme, which is in face of the dunya. So the first meme is in facing the reality of the divine presence and Jibreel. The second meme is facing the creation. So whatever between the two memes are the knowledge that has to be sent out to the creation, to creation, to humanity. So they are preserved in the ya. That's why the beginning of the alphabet is alif, the ending of the alphabet is the ya. Allah, ya is Yasin, Yasin is the heart of the Holy Quran. Next time, inshallah, we'll explain it deeply. وَمَيْنَ اللَّهِ التَّوْفِيقِ بِحُرْمَةِ الْفَاتِحَ شكراً شيخ.